So, yesterday over on the Elden Ring Twitter, they gave us some very interesting stuff to work with in terms of trying to figure out exactly what happened with the shattering and give us a little more context for what we actually got to play in the network test. And this one was very interesting because there was actually a lot of debate over what it could possibly mean. So before we dive into that tweet, I want to quickly follow up on something I talked about in the last video, and that pertains to this weekly Famitsu issue that's going to be featuring a little bit about Elden Ring. Now, it was confirmed that this is going to be an interview with Miyazaki, and you guys helped me find out that Ico is actually one of his favorite games, and that it helped inspire a lot of what makes up Souls. So we don't know exactly what his interview is going to be over, but I think he'll definitely be referencing this and talking about some inspirations going into Elden Ring. Either way though, that's going to be coming out on the 16th, so that's something to look forward to, and we'll definitely cover it here on the channel. But we gotta cover this tweet first. Yesterday on the normal Friday tweet, they dropped this. A picture of Stormveil Castle with a caption that reads, "This contested legacy is said to protect the remnants of a betrayal that shattered the lands between." Now, we have a lot to break down in that. This tweet is pretty obviously referencing the Shattering War that broke out between the demigods, the children of Queen Marika, after obtaining the Great Runes, the fragmented shards of the Elden Ring. And the first thing that came to my mind is, why is it the Shattering War that, in quotes, shattered the lands between, rather than the physical act of shattering the Elden Ring itself? And that idea right there makes me think this possibly isn't actually referencing the war itself. However, for a moment, let's explore the idea that it is. So in order for a betrayal to happen and trigger a war between all these siblings, it needs to involve something they all share. And the thing that I believe they all shared prior to the shattering was indeed Stormveil Castle. And we have a few signs that point to that. And our biggest clues, to me at least, are the paintings. We see the one of the big dude with the lion over his shoulder in the grafting room, and then the painting with Odovis standing in front of it that's probably 99% likely to be King Godfrey. And that makes me think that Stormveil Castle was probably the original place where the royal family lived. So now we have a few contestants to who could have been the betrayer. And the first obvious choice is Godrick the Golden. Godrick, as we all know, is not the original ruler of Stormveil. It's likely he either usurped the throne or was handed it by the person who actually betrayed their kindred. And we'll talk about that in a second, but I think Godrick is more of a lackey who followed in the footsteps of somebody who is much more powerful and much more driven to do something evil. And the quote that I've seen thrown around a lot to insinuate that Godrick was the betrayer is obviously the one of, "He was born a weakling child and coveted the strength of his kin." And I really don't think Godrick has the power to do something so magnificent that it destroys the entire land. But I think there is somebody else who is in Stormveil that could. This unnamed character here that is very likely a demigod is probably our culprit, and we have a few signs to suggest this. The first piece of evidence is that, at least from what we've seen so far, he seems to be the most prominent character in Stormveil. We see that his painting is the largest of what we've seen so far, and the motif of a lion is all throughout Stormveil Castle. Now, that doesn't mean a whole lot by itself, but we can also see that Godrick wields a similar axe to him, with a striking lion motif on the handle. So my theory is that after his betrayal of whatever it was, Godrick either usurped the castle or was left in place by him to keep the others out in his absence. But it makes me question, where could he be now if he's not still at Stormveil Castle? And for that, I want to look at this scene. I believe this is the same lion that we see in the painting. And we've discussed this in the past, so I'll explain why I think that. Now, as for the lion in the background, I have seen a lot of people comparing it to the Wolf Knight or the Lion Knight, whatever it is, in the Summer Games Fest trailer, so let's go ahead and take a look at that. When we compare the two side by side, there actually is a strong number of similarities here. We can see that the mane and the beard are very similar. Even the helmet that the knight on the left wears is in a similar shape to the crown. While it's not exactly the same, the one on the left is big and it could be covering the crown beneath. They both have this humanoid shape with arms that bend like a human's, and the armor that lines their shoulder is plated the same while it's not exact. So there's a pretty good chance that these are the same character. But after some further observation about this scene here in this boss fight, if these are the same character, this does further prove that that guy in the painting is the betrayer. Take a look at the red magic that we see come from his sword. After playing the network test, we now know that that is blood magic, which is used by servants of the Lord of Blood. Now, that's about the only context for this that we have, sadly, but I think it's safe to assume that the Lord of Blood is an enemy of the royal family, at least in their prime. But what if this is not talking about the Shattering War? What if it's instead talking about the actual shattering of the Elden Ring? Then we have a little bit more room to play around with. And I want to go back to the original trailer we got for Elden Ring because I think it reveals a lot of stuff that we looked over. The network test gave us a lot of context to come back to this trailer and give it a second look with more insight. For example, we now know that Marika was one of the people down there shattering the ring, if that is what they were doing, so this could be seen as the betrayal in a sense. And we're fairly sure that the Elden Ring is inside the Erdtree, at its base. And the two quotes that we got from Melina in the short time that she provided us a little lore really drove home this idea. The first of which is she's searching for her purpose given to her by her mother inside the Erdtree, and then that all we need to do is take her to the foot of the Erdtree. Now, we know that this scene of them actually hammering on this anvil and likely shattering the Elden Ring actually takes place inside the Erdtree, because we can see giant roots in the background if we turn up the brightness. So it's probably inside the Erdtree, but let's look into this a little bit more. If we take the idea that Marika is one of the people there at the event, then we need to look into who the other person is, the male. And I think the most likely candidate for that person is King Godfrey. Now, that's not a shot in the dark, we do have some evidence to suggest this. And the first bit comes from the item description for the meteorite spell. And in that item description, it says it was used by a great white king with stone skin. And we can see in this scene that their skin is shattering like it's made of stone. Now, the painting that I believe to be King Godfrey doesn't exactly line up with the character we see here, but we can go even further. There's even more evidence for King Godfrey being the Great White King with stone skin. And for that, we need to look to the Evergoals. I've heard the idea thrown around among the community that the Evergoals are tied to King Godfrey. We know they use this gravitational magic to teleport us to a certain boss fight. Now, the only one that we got to see in the network test was Bloodhound Knight Darawil. But with this, we're able to go back to the Summer Games Fest trailer and see something very interesting. We can see that Ordovis is also an Evergoal boss. So this has led people to believe that the Evergoals are going to be our key to go and fight the 16 Crucible Knights. Now, we don't have any sign that Darawil is one of them. However, minor spoiler warning here. Some people were able to glitch out of bounds and find another Evergoal with a fight with a Crucible Knight. However, that one was not Ordovis. So the connection there is a little bit small and it is kind of a stretch. But if we think about the parents of the demigods shattering the Elden Ring, I think that would be a perfect event to result in shattering the lands between and triggering a war between the siblings of them squabbling over the territory left behind in their parents' absence. But then again, if Godfrey and Marika did rule the lands between back when it was perfect, why then would they destroy their own land? I think there's three possibilities. Number one, and the most basic of all, is they just decided to become evil for whatever reason. Number two, they were manipulated into doing it by some unknown force. And number three, the one that I think is probably true, if this speculation does turn out to be correct, would be to either contain or hold off a force that is far worse than anything the shattering could cause. And that's what I'm going to be looking out for going forward. But anyways guys, that's going to pretty much do it for the video. That's my speculation on this tweet. Let me know what you think down in the comments below, and what you think this betrayal was. Either way though, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like on it and subscribe if you're new around here, and I'll catch you in the next one.